We begin now with the latest developments in the tragic B-17 crash out at Bradley International Airport. Good Thursday afternoon, everyone, and thanks for joining us here on Western Mass News at 5. I'm Chris Pisano.
And I'm Beth Ward. Tonight we are learning more about who was on board the doomed plane. Among the victims, three are from here in Western Mass.
In the meantime, the NTSB continues to comb through the wreckage, the agency releasing this video just a short while ago. And take a look at what's left of that B-17 after it crashed onto the runway yesterday morning right into a de-icing facility. Investigators are trying to determine what caused the bomber to go down in flames.
We have live team coverage covering the victims, their families, and we dig deeper into the plane's history. First, let's go to Jordan Jagelinzer on the NTSB's latest information. Jordan?
Chris and Beth, the NTSB just wrapped up their press conference a little while ago. They spent all day surveying the wreckage at that scene. The NTSB says right now they are going over pictures and videos that were sent in by the public. They say surveillance video from the airport shows the timeline of when the plane took off and when it hit the de-icing building, which was a difference of 8 minutes. Investigators are interviewing pilots with the Collins Foundation, who they say are all volunteers. They have requested training records for the flight crew and other workers on the plane. As for that plane, it was a B-17G. There are 16 registered in the United States. The NTSB says there have been 21 accidents that they have investigated, resulting in 23 fatalities. These planes have four engines. The NTSB saying the pilot called air traffic control with an engine issue. They have secured that engine now. The engines are something in question.
Am I aware of accounts from witnesses that there may have been issues with the engine prior to takeoff? The answer to that is yes. We do have witness statements, not official statements, but some things that have been sent in to witness@ntsb.gov that have stated they saw work being conducted on one or two engines prior to takeoff. So that is a question we have both for the Collins Foundation and for other pilots.
The NTSB says tomorrow they will be documenting all the wreckage, writing down what they see on scene.